Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Explore with Suchita. Today I am going to show you how to prepare MTR style rava idli along with that mixed vegetable sagu. Please watch complete video without skipping for detailed recipe. Before that, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get latest updates of all my videos. Please like my videos and share it with your friends. Now for preparing rava idli, I have taken a pan and I am adding little oil, around 2 spoons of oil. And now I am adding 1 cup of Bengaluru rava or Bombay rava. I am adding another 1/2 cup, totally 1.5 cups of Bengaluru rava. We need to roast this rava in oil. We'll start getting good aroma from this rava. Until we get that aroma, we need to roast this, and we need to roast it in slow flame. I'm adding little more oil so that we'll get the good texture of rava idli, like spongy texture, porous texture. Once it is fried, I will show you. Now I have taken here another pan. I have added little oil. I am adding mustard, urad dal, channa dal, now I am adding finely chopped green chilies. Today I am using around 3 finely chopped green chilies. I am frying all the ingredients in oil. And now I am adding finely chopped curry leaves. Now this tadka, I am going to mix it with rava. Now rava idli mixture is ready. Now we need to allow the rava to completely cool, and then I will show you the making of rava idli. Now I have taken a cooker. I am adding soaked green peas. If you have fresh green peas, you can use that also. And now I am adding chopped carrot, chopped beans, and chopped potato. And you can add whichever vegetables you want. Now I am adding water, pinch of sugar, and little salt. Now I will pressure cook it for 1 whistle. Now you can see rava is completely cooled. Now I am adding salt for taste. And now I am adding cooking soda, normal soda. After adding salt and soda, mix it well. Now I am adding curd. Today I am using homemade curd. Today I will be using 1/2 curd and 1/2 water. The consistency should be same as normal idli batter consistency. Now I am adding 1 pinch of sugar. Why? Because I will be adding coriander. so that after cooking the color of the coriander should not change. So I'm adding pinch of sugar. You can see now it is in this consistency, same as normal idli batter consistency. Now I'm adding chopped coriander. Today, as I'm preparing MTR style rava idli, we need to use in slightly large quantity. You can see rava absorbed all the curd and water, it became thick. You can see it became thick. I'm adding little water and I'm adding little curd also. Once I will mix this and I will check the consistency. And after mixing, we need to allow it to rest for around 5 to 10 minutes, minimum 5 minutes. If we allow it to rest and again, it will become slightly thick. So now only I will adjust the consistency. Now it is in this consistency and I will allow it to rest for 5 to 10 minutes. Now I have taken here another pan, I have added little oil. Now I am adding one chopped onion. Few garlic. Small piece of ginger. And red chilies. And today I am using 4 badgi red chilies. And we need to fry this. And now I am adding few pieces of cinnamon, 2 cardamom. And now I am adding around 1.5 spoon of dhania. And now I am adding poppy seeds, we call it as gasgase, around 1 spoon. And little methi. And now I am adding tomatoes. Now I am adding freshly grated coconut. Once it is fried, I will switch off the stove and I will start grinding. Now I have transferred everything to mixer jar. I am adding little turmeric powder and then fried grams. Now I will make a fine paste. Now you can see I have prepared masala like this. And now I am greasing all the idli plates with oil. Now you can see rava idli batter is in this consistency. Now I am transferring it to greased idli plates. I am placing sliced tomatoes. And now I am transferring prepared rava idli batter onto greased idli plates. Now I have arranged it like this and I will steam cook it for around 10 to 15 minutes. And for the same pan I have added little oil and mustard, jeera, and I have added one chopped onion, curry leaf, Now I am adding little turmeric powder. Now I am adding prepared masala paste. Now after adding masala paste, we need to allow this masala paste to boil. Now I am adding little jaggery. This is for taste. Now you can see masala is also boiling. Now I am adding boiled vegetables. Now I am adding salt for taste. And finally lime juice. Now you can see vegetable sagu is ready. You can see after steam cooking it for around 15 minutes, it looks like this. We need to allow it to cool and then we can remove it from idli plates. Now you can see if it is cool, we can remove it like this easily. And I am transferring it to serving plate. Now I am adding little ghee on the top. Now you can see MTR style rava idli is ready, along with that vegetable sagu and ghee. Hope so you enjoyed my video. If you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get latest updates of all my videos. Please like my videos and share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.